Hello. In this video, we'll look at how to use GitHub Actions to automatically build Docker images and push those images to Google's Artifact Registry service. This is going to be a great service if we need to use those Docker images in services like Google's Kubernetes Engine or even services like Cloud Run. In this video, we'll be focused on this portion of the CI/CD process. Now that we have established what we're trying to achieve, let's jump into the Cloud Console to set up some of these resources. The first thing to do is set up an Artifact Registry repository for our Docker images. Since this is a brand new project, we'll need to enable the API. Once the API is enabled, we'll create the repository and give it a name. I do recommend using a regional as opposed to a multi-regional repository, since the multi-regional is a good bit more expensive. The cost will be low if we only have a small number of images and don't have extensive vulnerability scanning, but in any case, a regional configuration makes sure that as this repository scales and you start to use additional features like security scanning, the cost will be relatively low. With our repository created, let's go ahead and start creating our Docker and GitHub Actions assets. In our IDE, let's create a Docker file for our build, and we'll also set up a workflow file. This YAML file will have the specification for our GitHub Actions workflow that's going to build this Docker image. For this Docker image, we're going to use a really simple Docker file. We're just going to have a Hello World HTML page that we're building on top of an Nginx-based image. Now let's get this automated in our build workflow on GitHub. First, we need to give this workflow a name, like deploy Nginx. We need to decide when we're going to run this workflow. So in this case, we're just going to say that on any commit pushes to our main branch, we'll run this workflow. Then we need to specify the job itself, and we're going to choose to run this on Ubuntu. For the first step, let's check out the code, and we'll just use a standard Actions plugin for that. To give ourselves a little bit clearer steps here, we'll add some spacing. Next, we need to install the gcloud CLI. Let's use a plugin for this, which will make our lives easier, and we don't have to write pure bash. We're going to need to set the project ID and some other settings for this plugin, which I'll paste in here. Now, notably, we're specifying some secrets here for the Google project and the application credentials. We'll need to fill those in later in GitHub, but we do know that we're going to need those. Next up, let's build and push our Docker image. We'll need access to that Google project secret in this particular step, but we're otherwise going to use a command line-based approach for our build and push step here. We're going to first configure Docker using that gcloud configuration that we set up in the previous step and export it. Then we're going to run our build. It's easiest to just get the path for our build from our repository itself, so I'll copy that and paste it here with the name Nginx latest. We also need to provide a build context, which will be the current directory, which is in the root where we have our Docker file. Lastly, we just need to push that image. All right, so we've got essentially everything we need here. We're checking out the repo, authenticating with Google Cloud, and then configuring and using Docker to push our image. Now let's set up a repo and get started with the GitHub Actions configuration. We're creating a new repository here. We'll give it the name GitHub Actions GCP Demo, make the repo private, and create it. In the Actions portion, note that we don't have anything running yet because we haven't pushed our code and triggered those actions. So let's go ahead and commit some code and push it. Now note that for the project, we can use the secret or provide it hard-coded since we copy-pasted that repository from earlier. Just for the sake of example, let's replace this with the environment variable. Ideally, we don't want to expose these project IDs in our potentially public repositories and workflow configurations. The workflow is looking pretty good. We have our initial commit here. Now, before we push, let's set up those secrets in GitHub Actions, which will involve some service account and IAM setup in Google Cloud. We need to go to the settings, then secrets and variables in Actions. We need to create a new repository secret. Make sure the names match exactly. Then we're going to need some credentials, which we'll create in the console. We'll go to IAM and service accounts to set up a service account that we can use for this GitHub Actions workflow. We're not going to assign any permissions yet because we're going to do that in the artifact repository. Let's copy this service account email and go into our artifact registry and our repository. If we just select this repository, we can see the interface for permissions in the info panel. We'll add a principal, paste the GitHub Actions service account, and then give that service account artifact registry repository administrator privileges to manage artifacts in this repo. You could theoretically pare this down a little bit, like artifact registry writer, for example. Now that we have the permissions we need for the service account, we just need to use it. Going back to the service accounts page, we'll click to add a JSON key. Bring that JSON key into our IDE. If you're following along, make sure you don't commit these files as they will allow access into your projects using that service account. We're going to put the service account key here and see the JSON content for that service account key. Grab that whole string and in our GitHub action secret, use that for our Google application credentials. We have the two secrets we need now, and we've set up the required permissions for that service account, so we're looking pretty good. Let's go ahead and push our code to that remote Git repository. In the repository, we should see the code now show up as well as our initial commit starting to run with GitHub Actions, no additional configuration necessary. Our action has run successfully. If we go back to the repository from earlier, we will see that the artifact shows up and we did successfully push it. With our image now in artifact registry, we can secure and manage that artifact, scan it, and then use it in our applications very easily using services like Kubernetes Engine or Cloud Run. We'll share the repository that we created in the description of this video, and we'll also watch the comments section for any questions. Thank you for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.